Hey, welcome to Intro to JavaScript, playing sound files with Tokyo EdTech. That is me. In this video, we are going to learn how to do some events. So we're going to have some buttons. We're going to click on those buttons. And when we click on them, we want to play a sound. We're actually going to be constructing a simple one octave piano keyboard. And we're going to be using some functions. This is vanilla JavaScript from scratch. No libraries, no nothing. And we're gonna need to use a little bit of HTML and CSS. So if you haven't done that before, this probably is not the video to start with. Go check out my HTML and CSS introductory videos. So let's take a look at what we have here so far. We have an HTML page. So if you notice from here to here, it says HTML. Down here, we have our script. Now, I'm not saying this is the best way to do it. This is an easy way for beginners to understand the organization. This is I teach high school students, and this is an easy way for them to kind of understand the organization. So inside the head, we have the style tags. So this is where we're gonna put some of our CSS later. So you can see I've already added an H1, so I've got a title, and I've got the 12 notes of the normal, I guess, Western musical scale. So notice we have A sharp, B, C, there's no B sharp, and there is also no E sharp, that is F, and B sharp is C. So let's go ahead and get started, because we got a lot to do, and I think it's going to be pretty cool. So I'm kind of doing this from memory, so we'll see if I can get this done. So what we want to do, or what we need first, if we're going to play sounds, is we need some sound files. So I went on Google, I Googled, I found this random Reddit post that had links to some MP3 files. And so what I did was I downloaded those, and I'll put the link down below. I downloaded those files, it's called MP3 notes, and you'll see here a bunch of MP3 files. Okay? And my file here, my HTML file, is saved into the exact same folder. If it's not in the same folder, it's not gonna work. So those of you that don't know how to manage your files, figure that part out first. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at A5. We're gonna do A-5. That's just how they labeled sharp. So that's gonna be A sharp 5. So we're gonna do A5, A sharp 5, B5, C5, C sharp 5, etc., etc. So all of these files are here in this folder. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and get that out of our way. Okay, so let's go ahead and create a button, because we're just going to make a bunch of buttons. So button, and our first note over here is A. So I'm going to go ahead and create a button A. I'm going to save it, refresh it. Let's see what we got here. Okay, there's a tiny little button. Now we're going to go ahead and make it look like a piano here in a little bit. But first, let's go ahead and focus on the JavaScript, since that's the title of this video. Let's get the JavaScript side working, and then we'll go ahead and make it look pretty. So what we want to do is we want to, when we click this button, we want to play that MP3 file. So the first step we need to do is we need to create our sound objects. Now, I'm a very logical person, so I'm going to create a variable. I'm going to call it A5 because that's the note we're playing. Notice I kept it lowercase just to be consistent with everything. And it is going to be new audio. And I can put this in single quotes or double quotes, doesn't really matter. A5.mp3. Okay, it says that is the name of the audio file over here. So you can see we got A3, A4, A5. I'm just using the fifth octave. You can do whatever you want to do. And later you can add the third and fourth octaves as well. Okay. So this creates the sound object, but it doesn't play it. Okay. So to do that, we're going to create some functions to play the sounds. So I'm going to call my first function, go figure, play A5. Note, I made this one capital, just that's kind of the naming convention I'm going to use here, parentheses. And it's very simple. I'm going to do A5.play. Okay, note the parentheses, note the semicolon. So let's go ahead and save it. I'm going to refresh this, and I'm going to run it. I'm going to click this. Now, I do not hear a sound. I assume you do not hear a sound either. Okay. And so if you've done a little bit of, you know, coding in JavaScript and HTML before, you might realize we missed a step, which was the event. Okay, so what we want to do is we want to use an onClick event. So when we click on that button, we want to call this function. It's very easy to do. We just do onClick equals, and I'm going to double quotes. And the function we're going to call is play A5, parentheses and semicolon. So I'm going to save that. I'm going to refresh it. And hopefully, you should be able to hear it in the microphone. Okay, I don't know how well it's coming through, but let me turn the volume up here. Maybe I can't turn it. There we go. Okay, so we have some sounds. So this is the basic concept. Okay, I'm just going to apply this basic concept to the other notes. But I'm going to show you a way to do this a lot easier. But let's just go ahead and just for fun, let's go ahead and add A sharp. And this is something I tell my students. Look at the pattern, okay? Once you have one button working, it's very easy just to copy and paste and make the changes that you need. So let's go ahead, I'm gonna copy that. There's three parts we gotta copy. I'm gonna copy that, paste it, and I'm gonna copy this function and paste it. So we wanna do A sharp, okay? And again, the way that this particular file is saved, it's A-5. So let's go A-5. And let's play A-5 and A-5. Okay. Now you can see how the colors have changed. I'm doing this for a reason. So let's go ahead. I've saved it. I'm going to refresh it. So let's try A. Okay, no sound, no sound, nothing. And the reason is that we can't use a dash. Oops, this should have been A5 as well. I can't use a dash because it interprets it as a minus sign. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to use an underscore. Okay, so instead of a dash, I'm going to use underscore. I'm going to use underscore. But the file name, it doesn't matter. Because it's a file name, I can just use dash, or I could rename the file name to underscore. When I gave this to my students, I just renamed it for them to make their lives easier. But let's test it. I've saved it. I've refreshed it. Okay, A sharp is not working. What did I do wrong? Ah, I forgot to change it up here. So you gotta keep track of all these different things. Now in a minute, I'm gonna make all this moot. It's not gonna matter. But it's important to know that this is a way to do it. Okay. Now the other thing is, like, if you try to click A, you have to wait till the previous note is done. There's a way around that, but we're just gonna do it this way for now. So that basically, I can stop there. This is what I wanted to show in this video, okay? Was how do I play a note when I click a button? So just to review that, okay, so I've made a function for each note. I've made an audio file, an audio object for each note, okay? Again, the file name has to match exactly. Capitalization is probably pretty important, at least depending on your operating system. Okay. And then in the function, I just play it. And from the click, I call the function. So it's kind of like a 1, 2, 3 parts to play a sound file. It's really that simple. Now, if we were to continue this, I would need to make, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'd need to make 10 more functions. And I can do that. That's what a lot of my students did when we tried this, and there's nothing wrong with that. But as I like to tell my students, I'm kind of lazy. I don't want to do it that way. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and create a new function. And I'm going to go ahead and delete these two. And I'm going to call this function, we can call it play note. I think that's what my students liked. And then I'm going to use note in here. I'll explain that in a second. And then note.play. So this function, okay, So I need to change this up here. So what I'm gonna do is when I call the function, I'm gonna tell it exactly which note I want to play. Okay, so I'm gonna go up here, I'm gonna say play note, and it's gonna be A5, and that A5 comes from here. So A5. Notice there's no quotes or anything here. It's not a string. So A_5, that's gonna be my A#. So play note. All right, so let's go ahead and test it. And I always tell my students, before you do anything, anytime you make a change, test it, make sure it works. Let's refresh it, and it should still play. Okay, I'm still hearing A#. And so you can see now, one function will take care of every note that I wanna play. So like, you know, a piano has 88 keys. So instead of making 88 functions, I can just make one function that does everything. So the next step here is what I might consider doing is just doing a lot of copying and pasting. Well, actually, tell you what, let's do it a slightly different way because we're gonna have to do something else. So again, at this point, you could stop and kind of try it out yourself and see if you can figure out how to get the rest of them working. But what I wanna do now is I wanna do a little bit with the CSS. Okay, so I want the, like, I mean, whole, I don't know what you call these, the non-sharp notes. I'm not sure what they're called. Sorry, musical people. I want non-sharp notes to, these are like the white piano keys. And then the sharp notes are the, like, the thinner black keys on a piano. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make two classes. So let's say normal. Okay. And I'm gonna make another one, I'll call it sharp, since it's sharp, in my CSS. Again, if you haven't done CSS before, I mean, I'll talk you through it here, but you should probably come into this with a little bit of CSS knowledge. So what we want is we want the background color to be white. We want the text to be black for the white keys. And then for the black keys, it's gonna be reversed. So let's go ahead and try this. And see how that goes. And we'll go ahead and refresh that. And you can see, it still works, but nothing happened. And this is what things I like to explain to my students, I like to show this to my students. So students will do this and they'll say, well, it didn't change, it's broken. And it's not broken, it's just it's not finished yet. So the computer doesn't know that this is normal and this is sharp. So we have to tell it down here, this button is a class normal, and this button is class sharp. So I'm gonna save it, I'm gonna refresh it. Now we can see this is white with black text, this is black with white text. Pretty cool, okay? Now the next thing I might say is like, well, they don't really look like piano keys. So let's go ahead and fix that. So let's go ahead and make the height of the normal key, let's make that, I think I did 150 when I practiced this, PX. And we'll make the width 50. Try that, see what it looks like. And let's refresh it. Okay, that's, again, notice it's still working, which is good. So let's do the same thing here, but make it slightly different, slightly smaller, because those keys tend to be smaller, keyboard. So let's say a height of, I don't know, 100, and a width of 30. Let's just try it, see what it looks like. And okay, that looks really good, except it looks kind of strange because it's centered. And so I think it's vertical. I should look this up. Vertical align and top. So I'm pretty sure for the sharp, we have to do vertical align, and that will move it to the top. Let's, fingers crossed. Yes, fantastic. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with this. The only other thing I might do here in the style is change the body color. So the body Notice it's not a dot because it's a HTML tag. So I might say background color. I don't know what a good background color is. Let's try brown, since that's kind of a wood color. Let's see what happens there. Okay, I can live with that. It's not pretty, but it works. So we've got a little CSS. It's giving us some design elements. It looks a bit more like a piano key because we got the big white keys and the smaller black keys. They're still working. Again, notice how everything works together, the HTML, the CSS, and the JavaScript. So the next step of this would be to add all of the rest of the keys. Okay, so B, C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, and G sharp, and to test them. At this point, probably what I would do is, you know, the next one is B and then C, so they are gonna be normal. So that'd be B, then C. So I'll just do those parts for you. So B and C. So it's gonna be B5, it's gonna be C5. Now if I run this, and this, I've watched my students do this, refresh it. Okay, the keys came up, I'm happy, that looks good. So let's go click it, and they'll tell me, well, no, it's not working. And of course, because we skipped a step. Okay, we didn't actually create the sound objects for those notes. So I'm gonna do B5, C5, B5, and C5. So let's go ahead and save it, refresh, and test it. Pretty, pretty cool. Okay, so that's it. That's what I really wanted to show you here. With a little bit of CSS, maybe these should be a little bit wider, I don't know, but you can play with the sizes and stuff. A little bit of CSS, a little bit of HTML, okay, so use some CSS classes. We used the onClick to determine, you know, the way that we're going to interact with this these buttons. Okay, we're calling a particular function, okay? We're telling it which note to play. Okay? But first we have to create the sound objects, which sound object to say to play. And again, it's a logical name, because we could have A4, we could have A3. You saw all that in the files. But what's nice about it is because our function is generalized, okay, we only need one function. So each function kind of takes care of one job. And because we are sending the values here, we don't have to have function play A5, function play A_5, function play B5, function play C5. We have one function that does everything for us. So yeah, that's it. So just kind of basically pretty quick review there. So we talked about events, playing sounds, functions, and how to use one function to take the place of many functions. And I think that's it. We've done our job. JavaScript, we played some sound files. I'll leave it to you to create the rest of the piano and to kind of play around with that and see what you can get working. And yeah, like I said, I'll put a link to the sound files because that's really key. If you don't have the sound files, it's not going to work. But appreciate you watching. Thanks for following along. And as I like to say, keep on coding. Take care.